Hillary's campaign made quite evident that the blue-collar FDR, New Deal, Truman, Fair Deal, Lyndon Johnson, Great Society core of the Democratic Party had changed, and that now the key issues were social. Right to choice, equal pay, the rights of women and girls, as Hillary's fond of saying, men and boys aren't supposed to have any rights, the treatment of the LGBT community, and so forth. How did those issues come to dominate the Democratic Party? I believe to its political disadvantage. It all started in the early 70s when Roe v. Wade was decided, I think 74, that permitted abortion in all cases throughout the United States. Before then, abortion was legal only in a handful of states, and most recently New York State had switched to legalize abortion under the impetus of Nelson Rockefeller, its Republican governor. Nixon himself was fairly pro-choice, but the issue had not really crystallized until the Roe suit brought it about nationally. There ensued a decade in which the conservative right took over the Republican Party and moved out the liberals who were pro-choice, and the entire party became staunchly pro-life with increasing purity over the years. Reagan embraced that and put that over the top as a key Republican issue. That led to a Democratic reaction in support of Roe, in support of the pro-choice position, which came to dominate Democratic Party rhetoric in 1980, 84, and 88 in the candidacies of Carter, Mondale, and Dukakis. In 92, Bill Clinton dragged it back to an economic focus with his promise to focus like a laser beam on the economy. But the left soon took over the party again, and feminist rights and LGBT and abortion all became again the central topic of discussion, all the more so when they nominated Hillary Clinton, the first woman to run for president. That takeover, which essentially mirrored a demographic takeover of the Park Avenue Democrat, the limousine liberal, the Hollywood producer, the Silicon Valley expert, the Harvard professor, all taking over a party that was originally composed of blue-collar, ex-union member Democrats. And it led to a fundamental repositioning of the Democratic Party, which in turn opened the way for Trump to get the votes of a lot of those former Democrats who felt the party had forgotten its economic issues by carrying the industrial heartland states of Pennsylvania, Michigan, Wisconsin, and Ohio. Thanks for watching.